interesting, innovative biennials right now are the Shanghai Biennial, which just opened, the Kochi Biennial, and the Shasha Biennial. And maybe also the biennial in Dakar. Kochi is a very important biennial because it has learned from the failures of other biennials. Learned from the failures because it's not just about city marketing. It's not about importing international culture. It's not about investing through dealers and collectors to make works which then can go onto the market. Kochi learned that this is about the future. It's about the future of a region, but also of a country, and it's a bottom-up phenomenon. It's a bottom-up phenomenon because, sadly enough, the public government of India in Kerala, they probably think that this is important, but they don't act like this. And I always say, if you start to study the economical impact on Kerala, on Kochi, but also India, of Kochi, biennial, then you will be confronted with the fact that it's an important economical, social contribution. The Kochi Biennial is not restricted to these demands of the West that whenever you do a biennial in Africa, in Northern Africa, in the Middle East, or in Asia, that it has to be about post-colonialism. This Kochi Biennial is freeing itself up from all these restraints of other biennials. It's not about marketing. It's not about tourism. It is really a people's biennial. And how can we convince the public government to say, listen, if you believe in heritage and in tourism, then you have to believe in this biennial. But if you believe that without culture we have even less, you also have to believe in this biennial. If you believe that the art, contemporary art of Kerala and the contemporary art of India is important and can speak to the world, then you have to invest in this biennial. What's also interesting for me, that probably the Kochi Biennial is showing us about the Museum of the Future. The Museum of the Future is not anymore about these vast, huge buildings, enormous buildings which gets bigger and bigger. The Museum of the Future will be more simple, more humble, will be flexible, will be pop-up, will be dealing with the old and the future. And the Kochi Biennial is almost like a blueprint for the Museum of Tomorrow. And that makes it so interesting. So there are many things in which the Biennial of Kochi is completely taking a new point of departure. What could constitute a biennial? What can it contribute to the local situation? What can it contribute to the national or regional situation? And what can it contribute to the international situation? Because suddenly you see Chinese representatives, suddenly you see representatives of the Gulf, of course you see Europeans and Americans, but here we come in order to think about how can we make things differently. And the Kochi Biennial is not only making a difference, it's also showing us the way how to make things differently. The difference between the first biennial and the second biennial is that here you see that the oeuvres which are made, they are more free than the oeuvres we saw in the first biennial. They are more free because there is a form of self-confidence. There is a self-confidence in terms of reaching outward. You know that you don't have to speak it for your own community, but artists are becoming aware that they can speak for other communities as well, without becoming it in a kind of international language. I wish that the Kochi Biennial would create a partnership with Shasha. I wish the Kochi Biennial would create a partnership with what's happening right now in Australia, with the Biennial of Sydney. I wish that the Kochi Biennial would create a partnership with Shanghai. And I think the future of biennials is to create partnerships between biennials. And that's something, a new thing. I think that's much more important than import-export. That's much more important than inviting artists through the Goethe Institute, through the Swiss Institute, through the British Council to come here and show their work. That's important, but I think we have to be a little bit more ambitious. So I wish for the Kochi Biennial that there would be a new form of working on an international cooperation through partnerships with other biennials which speak also in different way about the region. I think the Kochi Biennial is perfect because it is really in a subconscious way saying what happens if we speak from within and from the outside.